Good evening. Terezin Music Foundation is delighted to be among the co-sponsors for this very special event. And very appropriate for Virginia Eskin to join us in the musical offering tonight. Ginny has joined me in performing and championing the music of the Holocaust for close to 25 years, not only in the United States, but throughout Europe. And the work that she's going to perform tonight, it's a piano sonata that was composed in Terezin by Gideon Klein. You'll hear a couple of movements of it. Gideon Klein, at the time, was 24 years old. And in listening to survivor testimonies, they would recall this great, huge talent, not only as a pianist, but a composer and a conductor. And in fact, it was not unusual to hear some of these survivors say they would refer to him as our young Leonard Bernstein. Just a real tremendous loss. You'll notice it's not the piano we'd like, a concert piano. But I think in some ways there's something very appropriate about this. If you could imagine when Klein had composed this in 1943, first off, the piano there in Terezin, it had been brought in the hayloft, in the hay cart. And it was placed on these sawhorses. And they just, with the materials that were at hand, had to try to get this piano to be, you know, just reasonably functional. And then the other thing I want you to think about as you hear this music, when it was performed in Terezin, people didn't sit in seats like we're sitting tonight. People, if they were lucky, they sat on boards that were put on top of carts or pieces of luggage that were brought in from the transports. Some of them stood on the sides or in the back. When it was performed, actually the first performance was in the winter, and it was actually a rather brutal winter. There was no central heat. All right, a very different environment. Not to mention all the other factors of deprivation, death. And yet, what did that moment mean for these people to hear music? What did it mean to hear music by a young composer who was among them as a prisoner? Such a great talent, who was creating there in that environment. In that audience, I should also add, was his sister, Lischka Kleinova. And just as a further history, this piece, when we recorded this particular piece, Virginia was with me in Amsterdam. And then we went, after we finished the sessions, the next night performed the concert, and at that night, there was a Scud attack in Israel. It was the Gulf War, the first one, all right? And Lischka Kleinova was in that concert to hear her brother's music in Amsterdam, all right? So there's a lot of poignance to it for us, a lot of deep meaning. Also, it's a form of testimony. And I think that this, hopefully you will find that this music will be a great introduction into what is certainly going to be a very special evening of remembrance and reflection. Thank you.